Friends, welcome to Center for Online Education. Today, as we are dealing with a series of production management, and in the last lecture I have told you about the inventory management. So there are different types of inventory management. As I have told you, ABC, VED, economic order quantity, just in time. So one of the most important and highly used inventory control system is ABC analysis. It is being studied in production management as well as in the different areas of management. So let's explore that. What is ABC? ABC analysis classifies inventory items into three categories based on their values and importance. As you all know that whenever we are going to buy the raw material, it is very important that we used to see that what is the cost of that raw material and what is the value of that raw material and what is the standard in which we can keep that raw material. Sometimes the cost of raw material is very high and it requires special care to be taken so that the environmental impact on the raw material doesn't impact its quality. So when we talk about the A category, it is highly valued items, means it is a system where the cost of that raw material is very high, and to maintain that system, that there must be a reduction in the wastage, we used to buy this quantity as per the need of our production unit. Then there is a B system which says that the item must have a minimum value system. Medium means system means that it is somewhat cheaper than the higher class, and the quality in which it should be kept should be very high. The third one is the low value items, means the items which is being taken into consideration, it is of low cost, we can order it into bulk, and one time order can help the system to get an easy management process. So these are the three systems, A, B, C, always better control or activity based costing. Now let's understand and explore that what these three types of systems are. When we talk about the A items, typically the most expensive and most important should be managed with extra care and attention. Means it is the most expensive, the value is very high over here, and it is most important as extra care must be taken and extra attention should be paid so that there is a reduction in the process of wastage. Then you have got B items, which is important for the business success but not much as A. It means that here A is got bigger than B. Okay, so these are very important. Then the third one is the C items. C items is that their business process are not as important as the both the previous one. Now we'll take the example of ABC analysis model. Now when we talk about class A, okay, so here 20% of all your product comes over here. 20% of all your product comes over here, means the cost of a product is high. If you are going to buy a product of rupees 1 lakh, automatically you have got 20% of the values will be taken over, considered over here. Then highest annual consumptions, means consumption over is very high. Then the third one is, it is a valuable item. As I have told you that cement come over here, the cost of cement is very high. It must be kept in a proper way so that the use, the impact of environment is very less. It can be harmed by the water. So here the storage cost increases. When we talk about class B, 30% of your product is taken over here. Means when we talk about the bricks, bricks can be kept on roadside, bricks can be set in an open space, and it should have got an average annual consumption, means we can buy the bricks in a larger quantity as required in our system. Then less important item, as you say, the cement is a most important item because the chances of wastage of cement is more than the chances of wastage of bricks. Then the class
three items in which I have told you sand. So here 50% of all the goods are being taken. It is being produced, it can be buyed in a mass, and lowest consumption rate, you can use it in a less cost. Then the last one is least valuable items, as you can say that you can keep the sand anywhere because it is being least affected by the environmental impact. So in ABC analysis, you have got three classes of the product divided into the cost of the product and the quality of the product. The more higher the cost is, it will be kept into A section. The least cost of the raw material is being kept into C section, and according to its durability, we used to divide into class A, class B and class C. Now let's understand it by a specific graph. If you see that the inventory value over here means what is the cost of the inventory and the unit which is being used. So as you know that the A category, the cost is very high. As I have told you the example of cement. So here the cost is high and the unit is less. If you are going to buy the cement for rupees 10,000, automatically you are going to get 10 pieces of cement. But when you come to stone bricks, 10,000 brick, you will get, I think so, 5,000 or 2,000 bricks. And when it comes to sand, rupees 10,000 sand, you will get in a large quantity. So here you can see that the value and the unit is directly proportional to each other. The valuable product which you are going to consider in ABC analysis must have a proper setup so that the reduction of wastage can be made. While for C category, you require the minimum maintenance and the storage activity. Now, what are the advantages of ABC analysis? First one, it allows business to focus attention on the most important items. By focusing on A items, business can ensure that they are properly managed and stocked. This helps to ensure that the business has the items needed, and when needed in time, they can be accumulated. Means the first advantage of ABC analysis is this, that it can be divided into the cost of the product and the use of the product. So, as you all know that the A items are most costly items, and which any use of that A item is very important for the organization as a whole. No wastage has been required for the A items. Therefore, by the help of ABC analysis, it helps and it ensures that the quality of A items, inventories of A items must be properly kept. Second, it helps business to save money. By focusing on A items, business can save money by not wasting resources or managing and stocking unimportant items. Means here, by the help of ABC analysis, we can divide the inventory into the important one and non-important one, which has got the most important and which has got the least importance. And according to that, we can maintain our resources, we can maintain our inventory. ABC analysis provides business with greater control over the inventory. By focusing on the A items, businesses can better manage their inventory levels and avoid stockouts. Means by the help of ABC analysis, it is very vital, as the stockouts can easily be avoided. Means any organization who are producing any product can be have a proper resources of inventory on time. Reorder level must have proper maintained. So by the help of ABC analysis, we know that at what time we have to reorder the quantity. It helps business make better decisions. By understanding which items are more important, businesses can make better decisions about which items to stock and to manage them. Here, by the help of ABC analysis, our inventory has been divided into three parts, A, B, C. And here the management knows that what is most important and what has got the least importance. So here, by the help of the affirmation of the inventories, we know that for which the business should take an active and keen interest to keep that product in a better manner, and in which the inventory should be kept in a manner so that it required less attention than the A items. So these are the advantages of ABC analysis. four steps to implement ABC analysis. Now, what are the four steps to implementing the ABC analysis? The first one is gather data. Now, how you are going to gather data? The data can be analyzed, should be included in the sale inventory, inventory label, and the cost of the item. This information will be used to determine which items are the most important. As I have taken an example of construction of a house. So, while you are going to construct a house, you require different materials. Some materials have got a very high value and some materials are the least value. If you take an example of a sand, it has got the least value. You can buy the sand in a large quantity with a less amount of money rather than cement, which has got the higher cost, and keeping that cement must have got a proper storage because it has been directly affected by the rain or the moisture system. So here, gathering of data is very important, that what type of raw material you are using and how you are using that raw material and how you are maintaining that raw material so that it has got a proper impact on the finished good. Then second one is calculate the ABC coefficient. Means here when we talk about the ABC analysis, we used to see that our quantity of the product, raw material, and the price of the raw material is very important. We used to keep the data according to the price, according to the quantity. As you know that the more the quantity is, the most attention that product has been required. The less the quantity, the less concentration about the product is being required by the management. So the second step is this, that we are going to put our raw material into different category, whether it comes into A category, whether it comes into B category, whether it comes to C category, we put the product into different categories. Then classify the items, that after you are going to putting the product into that category, you are going to classify it. Classify it means according to the value of the product, items with the highest coefficient will be classified as A items. Items with the next highest coefficient will be classified as B. Items with the lowest coefficient will be classified as C. As I have told you that the most expensive items, the most expensive inventories are being kept into A category, while the least expensive or the inventory which have got the low cost are being kept into C category. Then implement control. Now you have classified the item that these are the inventories which is being required for any production unit. Now what you are going to do, you have classified it and now you are going to maintain a control. This control is all about maintaining the raw material so that it is being properly sent to the final product, it is being properly processed to the final product, it must be properly transported to the different machines so that the optimum utilization of the product is being done. So here the A item should be monitored closely and managed carefully, and the B item should be monitored and managed on the regular basis, and the C item should be monitored periodically. Means as the cost of the A items is very high, it must be taken into consideration that periodically it must be seen. For example, if you are going to see the cement, so every time you are going to order, 10 packs of cement or 100 packs of cement. But for sand, you can take 10 trucks or 15 trucks of sand. So like this, the items which are highly cost must be periodically assessed, and when there is a need, we used to buy that product as per the need of our production unit. Now, challenges using the ABC analysis. Now, what a challenge which a manager used to face when he is going to implement the ABC analysis. The first one is difficult to implement because as you know that for a production unit, you have to require the different raw materials. So for a manager, it is very difficult to maintain that level of raw material and kept that raw material into different categories. For example, sometimes there is a difference in the opinion about the managers. Some says that this is very important for this, while the other says that this is not important, while this is very important. So it depends upon the skill of the manager that what inventory he used to feel that it is important for the production unit. So on the basis of this, they are going to categorize the raw material into A, B, C category. So The theorem says that A, B, C category should be on the basis of the cost and on the basis of the maintenance. But sometimes due to the managerial activity and to the behavior activity of the manager or the skills of the manager, it cannot be same and they can change the system. Second one, doesn't consider demand pattern. You know, in economics, demand-supply relationship always goes side by side. We used to produce a lot of product, but there is no demand in the market, so it's of no use. So our product must match with the demand in the market. So for supplying of our product, there must be a demand in the market. So by the help of ABC analysis, it is a very challenging activity that we can maintain the raw material and we can convert that raw material into finished product. But we don't know that at what time that finished product is going to be consumed in the market. And whenever there is a stagnation between the making of the product, final product, and consumption in the market, automatically the ABC analysis is of no use because there is a stagnation in the use of the final product. And the third one is seasonal demand. Some product has got the seasonal demand. For example, when we used to talk about cold drinks, we talk about the summer. When we talk about raincoats, umbrellas, there must be summer, or you can say it's of a rainy season, right? When we talk about woolens, it is of winter seasons. So seasons has got an impact on the product and on the demand of that specific product. So here seasonal demand automatically affect the ABC analysis. As you know that in a specific season, the demand of the product is very high. So somewhere or the other, ABC doesn't have any relationship with the seasonal demand of the product, because you have to prepare the product as much or as per the requirement of the customer in that specific season. Then the last one is the lead time. Means the time by which the inventory is being put into machine and it is being taken out for the final product. So here, what is the time they take? And after that, the time which is being taken for that final product to be produced and sent to the market. So all these times are very important for inventory. If we buy a inventory of very high cost, but there is a dampness in the process of production, automatically the high consumed or the high value inventory is going to be of waste, and our working capital is somewhat stuck over there, which is not going to be helpful for the business as a whole. So ABC analysis has these four challenges. I hope that understanding ABC analysis on the basis of its demand, cost, and its maintenance, because it is one of the most important inventory control mechanism. We have to think and again think that what type of inventory control system which we have to use. Whether for our business ABC is important, whether VEDMs is important, just in time is important, economic order quantity is important. So this depends upon the managerial activity of a manager. A skilled and a very high qualified manager always used to apply the different inventory system as per the need of the organization or the industry. So it's definitely on the will of the management that what type of inventory system he should use. And it should be done in a proper manner, that it must be synchronized with the activity by having an optimum utilization of the resources, reduction of wastage, and getting our best product, quality product, to the market. So ABC analysis is all about the inventory, its cost, its maintenance. I hope you have understood. Thank you.